Hey, it's Fran again at my bench. And today I've got this little guy to show you. I found this in my bins going through the vault the other day and just had to give this little contraption its own little mini video. This is honestly a real flip-flop. And right off the bat, I know that people are going to say, "Oh, Fran, this is not a real flip-flop. You're getting that terminology all wrong, because by definition, a flip-flop is an electronic latch." Because I know, because I've been on the internet and I see that it was actually invented by a couple guys who made it out of, you know, triodes back in 1918, and it's always been electronic latching device and yada, yada, yada. Well, I say that this is a real flip-flop because unlike the electronic latches, this little gizmo really does flip and flop. So with a traditional relay-based flip-flop, you would have one of the poles of both of the relays used to hold current on one of the solenoids to keep the two relay flip-flop engaged one way or the other, and then use the other spare contacts in the relay for doing the switching whatever you want to switch. And by breaking that circuit one way or the other between the two different sets of contacts between the two different relays, you flip and flop. But that's not how this works. This actually has this little mechanical latch in the middle. The contacts are spring-loaded to be pushed towards the center. So this set of contacts is being pushed in, that set of contacts is being pushed in, and they meet between these two very unusual paddles so that when one side pulls in, and that little latch there holds the flip or the flop, depending on your perspective, and the same thing, when this side pulls in, click, okay. So this runs on 115 volts AC, so I'm going to make it a little more dangerous. Make it hot. Get it hot here. Okay, let's see the action. A little bit of oxidation. But yeah, it's a real flip-flop. It's just very pleasing. It's all right. So yeah, very simple, elegant, and effective. Just really neat. I'd never seen anything like this before. Don't really know how popular this would have been. It's an awful lot of machinery to do something that two relays would do very easily, but very fail-safe, and this has the advantage that it does not need to have one of the solenoids charged to hold the memory. You could think of it as like one of those magnetic latching relays where you just pulse here, pulse there, and it flips and flops, but there's no magnetism involved here. It's just spring tension and a little mechanical device with these two little paddles. It's just very neat. I like it. So anyway, well, that was a very long video for a very small, simple thing, but yeah. I'm going to be going through my bins every now and then, and when I find something interesting, I'm going to show it to you. All right, that's it. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to all of the people on Patreon who make all these videos possible, even these short little silly ones. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's really the only reason I'm able to do these videos, so if you like any of my videos, then maybe you could consider becoming a patron. It's just easy to do. You just go down in the description, click on the link, become a patron. Okay. I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench with something else real soon. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. Dessert in my lab, it's where I work. Uh-huh. you're watching. Friend, it's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.